लगता लिखो ना सर कि पावर पॉइंट से
हां
तो लिखो ना सर ही
दावा द मां पर पावर जो आज तीनों का रस्ता लिख दी थी बस आवाज
और द ए बी पास इंफॉर्मेशन जो है बिना स्टार द पॉइंटर पर वैल्यू शर्त है
ये द किस पे बदल रहा हुआ किस लेफ्ट साइड का
एरो ऑप्शन मैंने भी ऑटोमेटिक विजिबल विजिबल ही कम
इधर कम
विजिबल देखा ना तो एरो ऑप्शन कल होता है विधिमंडल का किंतु लोगों दायक पर होता है लिखा तो कुबस सही सो नेगेटिव हाफ वेव सर्कल सर्कट व्हेन एसी सप्लाई इज switch on the alternating voltage when starts appearing across the terminal A to B at the secondary winding of the transformer during the positive half cycle thus crystal diode is forward biased making a terminal A positive with respect to terminal B therefore it conducts the current flows through the load resistor. So positive half wave circle circuit. When AC supply is switched on, the alternating voltage will start appearing across the terminal AB at a secondary winding of the transformer. During the positive half cycle, the crystal diode is forward biased, making the terminal A positive with respect to terminal B. Therefore, it conducts and current flows through the load resistor. So, negative half wave circle circuit. During the negative half cycle, the crystal diode is reverse biased, making the terminal A negative with respect to terminal B. Under this condition, the diode does not conduct and no current flows through the circuit. Therefore, in negative cycle of the input voltage, no voltage appears across the load resistor. So application of half wave rectifier. ओ जालिमा आया तो उन्होंने रेडिट ना तो सारा वेट कर दिया हाँ
ये तो वही जिस तरह की जोर दिया आवाज इस तरह और
अली तो वर्किंग पर है तो उन्होंने तो सारे सिर ना तो उड़ा था ओके सा तो अली वर्किंग ना रखा है बात
उन्होंने तो फिर वो दे लगा एक क्वेश्चन ही ना दे लगा और जो इस पे कदा सुमर निकल गई
ना कौन रोये बात आ ਵੀਡੀ ਬੰਦਾ ਹੋ ਗਏ
ਵੀਡੀ ਬੰਦਾ ਸਭ ਉਸੇ ਪਰ ਖਤਰ ਆ ਜੋ
ਰੇਡੀਓ ਚ ਨਾ ਬੰਦੀ ਦੀ
ਹੋਰ ਇਸ ਮਸ਼ੀਨ ਤੇ ਖਰੀਦ ਹੋ ਰਹੀ ਆ
अस्सलाम वालेकुम माय नेम इज़ औरंगजेब एंड माय रजिस्ट्रेशन नंबर इज 17 NTO 00041 The topic of my presentation is Introduction to Crude Oil, Origin, Exploration and Production. So first of all, what is crude oil? Crude oil is a naturally occurring unrefined petroleum product composed of hydrocarbon deposit and other organic material. It is a type of fossil fuel. Crude oil can be refined to produce usable products such as glycerin, diesel and various other form of petrochemicals. So non-renewable resources, which means that it can't be replaced naturally at the rate we consume it and is therefore a limited resource. Raw natural resources. Crude oil is the raw natural resources that is extracted from the earth and refined into a product such as glycerin, jet fuel and other petroleum product. Global commodity. Crude oil is a global commodity that trades in the markets around the world both as spot oil and oil direct use contracts. Primary source of energy production. Many economists agree that crude oil was and remains the single most important commodity in the world, as it is the primary source of energy. So mixture of comparatively crude oil is a mixture of comparatively volatile liquid hydrocarbons. Through it also contains some nitrogen, sulfur and oxygen. Extraction and processing. Many economists agree that crude oil was and remains a single most important commodity in the world, as it is the primary source of energy. Uses of crude oils. Good fuels need to be readily available, easily transportable and inexpensive to produce. So there are some uses: carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide and nitrogen oxide. So carbon monoxide, a toxic gas formed by incomplete combustion in the internal combustion engine, and carbon dioxide, a major contributor to global warming via the greenhouse effect. Oxide, contributor to acid rain and destruction of forest. Products made from crude oil. After crude oil is removed from the ground, it is sent to a refinery where different parts of the crude oil are separated into usable petroleum products. These petroleum products include glycerin, distillates such as diesel fuel and heating oil. Origin of crude oil. Crude oil is formed from the remains of dead organisms such as algae that existed millions of years ago in a marine environment. Kerosene. The enormous pressure, high temperatures and lack of oxygen transferred the organic matter into a waxy substance called kerosene. So hydrocarbons, crude oil also hydrocarbons is also origin of crude oil. Crude oil is formed from the remains of dead organisms such as algae and zooplankton that existed millions of years ago in a marine environment. Dominant forms of organisms life. With even more heat, pressure and time, the kerosene undergoes a process called ketogenesis. As they like
इस पे वो डिस्कस करते हैं, उस पे फोर्सेस कितने लगते हैं, उसका मटेरियल किस चीज से बना है, किस चीज का वो बना हुआ है. तो इसकी जो है ना मेन ऑब्जेक्टिव जो है वो है स्ट्रेस, स्ट्रेन एंड डिस्प्लेसमेंट, एंड दिस वी आर डिस्कस दिस लेटर ऑन. देन व्हाट इज इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ मैकेनिक्स मटेरियल्स टू सेफ एंड सिक्योर एनी काइंड ऑफ डिजाइन स्ट्रक्चर. It means that if we made a design or any structure, then we first of all we checked the material, that what material he made, and after that we make a design. If we make a wrong material, a design or structure with a wrong material, then a failure may happen. The fundamental concepts. There are some fundamental concepts of mechanics of fabrics. The most fundamental concepts are stress. First of all, stress. What is stress? The force per unit area is called stress. Formula sigma is equal to force divided by area, and its unit is newton per meter square or pascal. some types of stress, normal stress, tensile stress, compressive stress. What is normal stress? In case of stresses act in the direction perpendicular normal to the cross section of the bar, these are called normal stress. And tensile stress, when the bar is stretched by the force P, the stress is called tensile stress. And compressive stress, the stress is known as compressive stress when we compress the bar. So strain, change in the dimension of an object occurs under the influence of an external load. Its formula is epsilon naught is equal to sigma divided by L, and it is dimensionless because it is the ratio between density and L. So there are some types of strain: normal strain, tensile strain, and compressive strain. So what is normal strain? The strain associated with a normal stress strain is known as normal strain, and tensile strain, when the bar is in a tension, the strain is called a tensile strain. That strain to elongated a bar, and compressive strain when we compress a strain and it shorten the bar, then it is called compressive strain. So stress and strain curve, load applied on testing machine and resulting a deformation, when we applied a force on the machine and the result they give in a deformation, it is called a strain curve. There are two type of load: static load and dynamic load. What is static load? Non-fluctuating load, that is a rate of loading is not interest, usually caused by gravity. And what is dynamic load? Dynamic load, it is an alternating load and can be a cyclic manner, और इसका जो मैग्नीट्यूड और साइन है वो लोड के साथ चेंज होता जाता है. तो हियर इज अ डायग्राम विच स्ट्रेन स्ट्रेन करो. इसमें हमारे पास जो ओ से ए तक जो का फासला है, ये हमें ये शो करता है कि ये जो स्ट्रेन स्ट्रेस जो है ना, ये सिर्फ लीनियर नहीं है बल्कि ये एक प्रोपोर्शनल है. सो ये जो स्लोप है ओ और ए का, इसको हम मॉडुलस ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी कहते हैं, क्योंकि स्ट्रेस डिवाइड होता है स्ट्रेन पे, और मॉडुलस ऑफ इलास्टिसिटी सेम यूनिट है, यूनिट स्ट्रेस के साथ सेम यूनिट है. So beyond the elastic deformation there is a plastic deformation. उसमें जो है ना हमारे पास जो है ना permanent deformation होता है, क्योंकि वहाँ पे हमारे पास strain totally recover नहीं होता. So between D and A there is a this portion is called elastic plastic portion. In this some of area are recovered and some are not recovered, which are a plastic state. Hooke's law. We state Hooke's law is that stress here is directly proportional to the strain. Sigma is equal to E epsilon naught, where E is the coefficient of modulus of elasticity, or also is it's called a Young modulus. There is a graph of Hooke's law. Large variation in the yard strength, unlimited strength, and final strain ductility, but same modulus of elasticity and stiffness. There are some materials which are gels, biological tissues have which have high elasticity, and then rubber which have ये उसके बाद उसकी थोड़ी सी कम होगी रबर की पर उसके.
If the action is good and positive, then his reward energetic him increase his strength, and if the reward or the action is negative, then basically it will receive negative rewards. Reinforcement learning components, there are two types of components. We also discussed the agent and environment, or it composed of two component, number one agent and environment. So here agentic action where in environment, when the agentic action in environment it change its state and also it receive a reward from the environment. If the reward, if the action is positive and that kind of action which may be which increase his strength, then the reward will be positive and vice versa. So basically there are two component in reinforcement learning. Number one, agent, and number second, and environment. What is agent? Agent, we can say that a machine which take any action, and number second is environment where the agent take action. Reinforcement learning components. So what are the components? The term of reinforcement learning. There are basically says 7 to 8 term. Number one is agent. We already discussed that an agent is an entity which perform action in an environment to gain some rewards. And environment, a scenario that an agent has to face. Basically, environment is a scenario where agent had faced to take any action, and rewards when agent take any action in environment, on the as a result he gain any rewards. And state refer to current situation returned by the environment. Policy. It is a strategy which applies by the agent to decide the next action based on the current state. Which apply by agent to decide the next action based on the current state. For example, the agent take any action, and on the performance of current state, he decided next action. Value, it is expected long-term return without discount as compared to the short-term rewards. And value function, it specifies the value of a state, that is the total amount of rewards. It is an agent which should be expected beginning from that state. Number next, model of the environment. This mimics the behavior of environment. It helps us to make inference to be made and also determine how the environment will behave. So basically it's deal with the environment, that how the environment will behave. Reinforcement learning terms. Number 7, model based method. It is a method for solving reinforcement learning problem which use model based method. Okay, on the basis of model based method, it solves its problem. Q value or action value. Q value is quite similar to value. The only difference between the two is that it takes an additional parameter as a current action. Reinforcement characteristic. Characteristic of reinforcement learning are there is no supervisor, only a real number or reward signals. Sequential decision making. For example, any in the decision making, it follows sequential method. Third, time play a crucial role in enforcement problem. And feedback is always delayed, not instantaneous. Okay, agent action determine the subsequent data it receives. Reinforcement learning types. There are two type of reinforcement learning. Number one is positive and the second one is negative. So what is positive? It is defined as an event that occurs because of specific behavior and those we can say that the agent takes such type of action which gives him energetic, which make his energetic. For example, here we also claim that it increases the strength and the frequency of behavior and impact positively on the action taken by the agent. And the negative reinforcement is defined as strengthening of behavior that occur because of a negative condition which should have stopped or avoided. So negative reinforcement learning, we also claim that we can say that it decreases the strength and frequency of behavior and impact negatively on the action taken by the agent. Thank you.
My name is Aurangzeb and my registration number is 17 and 00041. So my topic of presentation is that show that count of worst state is equal to 7972 per denier. So we have a given data that count in a given system, which is C1, is equal to count of worst state, and count in a required system C2 is equal to denier. Length of a given system L1 is equal to 560 yards, length of a required system L2 is equal to 9000 meter, and weight of a given system W1 is equal to 1 lb, weight of a required system W2 is equal to 1 gram. So and there is a solution of this equation. So first of all, we convert the length into same unit because they have a different units. So we have changed it to a same units. So change length L1 from yard into meter. First of all, we change the length L1, which is in yard, then we change into meter. We know that 1 yard is equal to 9.9144 meter. Multiply 560 on both sides. 560 yards is equal to 512.464 meter. So L1 is equal to 51.064 meter. So there is a length L1 which we converted into a meter from a yard. Then now convert W1 from pounds into grams. We have a weight in pounds, and this weight we change into grams. So as 1 pound is equal to 453.592 grams, so W1 is equal to 453.592 grams. Indirect to direct system. That how we change from indirect to direct system. Formula: C2 is equal to 1 divided by C1 into L2 divided by L1 multiplied by W1 divided by W2. L is the length and W is the weight. So denier is 1 divided by count into weight into 9000 meter divided by 512.064 meter multiplied by 453.592 divided by 1. So denier is equal to 1 divided by count into weight into 400 divided by 512.064. So denier is equal to 7972 divided by count into weight. Count into weight is equal to 7972 per denier. Equal to as 1 kg of yarn is equal to mass of moisture plus own dry mass of a sized yarn, and 1 kg is equal to 2.205 pounds. So inspect of 1 kg put 2.205 pounds. 2.025 pounds is equal to mass of moisture plus own dry sized yarn. Put the value of mass of moisture from equation 1 into 2. 2.205 pounds is equal to 0.06 own dry yarn sized plus y. Taking y common from right side. So 2.205 pounds is equal to own dry mass yarn sized into 0.065 plus 1. So this is equal to y is equal to 1.065 divided 1.065 on both side of equation. So there is an equation 2.0205 pounds divided by 1.065 is equal to own dry mass sized yarn. So y is equal to 0.070 pounds. Own dry mass of sized head is equal to 6% of own dry mass of yarn. So is equal to 6 multiplied by 2.07 per 100. So this is equal to 0.124 pounds. And this is the answer. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum. The topics of my presentation are, there are two topics of my presentation. Number one, rule and function of Lorentz. And the second one is rule and function of combing machine. So here we discuss first rule and function of combing Lorentz. So Lorentz, what is the function of Lorentz? First we discuss this. Lorentz is something that Lorentz is the starting of spinning operation, where we can open the fiber, clean and remove micro dust from the yarn. So it is a basic basic function of Lorentz. So here we also write something about that the basic rule, the basic role or function of Lorentz are opening, cleaning, dust removal, blending and evenly feeding the material on the card. So function of Lorentz, number first, Lorentz is the starting of the spinning wheel. So discuss that, where the fiber is open, clean, mix and micro dust removed. Simply we remove the dust particle or open the yarn in the Lorentz. Number one is opening mean to open the yarn. So opening is the first operation with the Lorentz, in which the goal is always a high degree of openness of material with a gentle treatment and a fiber loose as less as possible. Number second point is tearing apart the compressed and matted cotton until it is very much loose. The second point, it's mean tearing apart compressed and matted cotton until it is very much loose and separated into small tough yarn units with a gentle treatment. So the third point is the opening is also related to cleaning. Second main function of Lorentz is cleaning. What cleaning mean? Cotton contain up to 18% trash in most cases. To clean that material, it is unavoidable to remove as much fiber as much best. One is cleaning efficiency, that how much we measure the amount of the waste removed and its composition. So third point is the cleaning efficiency always has to optimize and not maximized. Dust removal, by name it's also clear that dust removal, to remove dust from the yarn, from the cotton, to extract the contamination in the cotton such as leaf, stone, iron particles and much more things from which are found in the fiber. Here we remove such particles from the cotton. The second point is removal of impurities. This also leaves strong iron particles, colored fiber, feather. These all are impurities. To remove these impurities in dust removal. So the third point is de-rusting in the blue room happen by air circling only either between the machine. For example, the dust cage, dust extractor, etc. are within the machine by a normal air separation capable of extracting dust. This is the structure of blue room. Number one is bell opener, mixer, pre-cleaner, fine cleaner. There's all the parts of blue room. The second topic of my presentation is combing machine. Combing machine. What is combing machine? The combing machine draw the combing process is normally used to produce smoother, fine, stronger and more uniform yarn. So what combing machine do? Draw smoother, finer, stronger and uniform yarn. These are the structure of a combing machine. Number one, lap. Number second, feed roller. Bottom nipper plate, upper nipper plate, top leaner comb, brushing cylinders, detecting roller and bottom rotary comb. These all parts we are discussing below. So operation sequence of combing machine. Number first of all, the lathe roller is mounted on the roller stand. This is the lathe, the first step. The second, the lathe feed first of all passes under the feed roller. Number third, as soon as feeding action get completed, so here in this point the feeding process is going to complete. After completing the feeding action, the upper nipper plate start to lower on the bottom nipper plate. These are the upper nipper plate and these are the bottom nipper plate. So what does it work? Nipper start to lower on the bottom nipper plate. Now combing action gets started. From this, combing action process is started. How the lap sheet come into the contact of bottom comb mounted on the rotating cylinder. The sawtooth of combs sweep the lap sheet. Now what's next? The nipper plate get open again and move toward detecting roller. It means while detecting roller have returned part of previously down of stroke by mean of reverse rotation. So the next point is, the next process is the detecting roller start to rotate in forward direction. Again, the draw the grip. So what next? Fiber out the web held fast by feed roller. So now upper come into action and come the trailing part of fiber fringe. The lip sheet come into the contact of button comb mounted of rotating contact of button comb mounted on rotating cylinder. So what does it work? It carry away the material which is not gripped by nipper plate. So now the detecting roller fixed and nipper plate open again to receive next feeding. So the next point, the brush cylinder help to remove the impurities from the button comb and eject them into a extractor that carry the nail away to a collecting filter system. All these mechanically, so we remember this, all these mechanically very demanding process step are carried out of 8 combing heads simultaneously at speed of up to rounded about 500 times per minute. Yeah, I study about it, round about 500 times per minute. Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Aurangzeb and my registration number is 17NTO0041. The topic of presentation is working of half wave rectifier. So what is a half wave rectifier? A rectifier circuit in which the half part of the cycle, either positive or negative of AC, is converted to DC is defined as the half wave rectifier. If the positive half cycle is considered, then the negative half cycle of the source gate blocks, and if the negative cycle of the source is considered, in that case positive cycle gets blocked. So working of half wave rectifier, the circuit consists of a single diode in series with the AC supply and the load resistor. Convert AC to DC. How we convert AC to DC? If the sufficient supply is provided, the diode converts AC to DC. There is a diode which are connect in the circuit. So this diode convert the AC to DC. The resultant will be undirectional by utilizing the half cycle of the supply. Positive side half wave rectification is carried out during the positive side of the supply, because as per PN junction diode concept, it is evident that diode conducts during forwarding bias. So half wave rectification for positive cycle consideration: when the circuit is provided with a positive half cycle, sufficient amount of voltage reaches the diode, resulting it to function in forwarding bias condition. Now in this type of rectifier, the diode direction is changed, so it begins to conduct during the applied negative supply of the voltage, and the positive cycle gets blocked. Wave rectification for negative cycle consideration. These have the same process as the positive cycle consideration, but in this the direction of diode is changed in the circuitry. Half wave rectified with capacitor filter. When the circuit is provided with a positive half cycle, sufficient amount of voltage reaches the diode, resulting it to function in forwarding bias condition. The purpose of the filter is to convert the blasting DC into its percent form. As the output generated at the load resistor is time varying, but coming to practicality, one cannot prefer blasting DC for any kind of electronic system. It requires DC in the percent form. Operation half wave rectifier. Half wave rectifier circuit comprises as a semiconductor diode with a load resistance RL. The diode is connected in series with the secondary of the transformer and the load resistance, while AC supply main connected to the primary of the transformer. It has basically two type of circle. The first one is positive half wave circle circuit, negative half wave circle circuit. So what is positive half wave circle circuit? When AC supply is switched on, the alternating voltage will start appearing across the terminal AB. Positive half wave circle circuit. When AC supply is switched on, AC supply is switched on, the alternating voltage will start appearing across the terminal AB at a secondary winding of the transformer. During the positive half cycle, the crystal diode is forward biased making the terminal A positive with respect to terminal B. Therefore, it conducts and current flows through the load resistor. So, negative half wave circle circuit. During the negative half cycle, the crystal diode is reverse biased, making the terminal A negative with respect to terminal P. Under this condition, the diode does not conduct and no current. Flows through the circuit. Therefore, in negative cycle of the input voltage, no voltage appears across the load resistor. So, application of half wave rectifier. Application half wave rectifier. The requirement of generating DC output voltage was on the way of the application of the half wave rectifier circuit with the filter attached across the load. In power supplies, circuitry where the constant DC at the output is not considered as the major requirement, at that case the half wave rectifier can be used. Working of full wave rectifier. Full wave rectifier basically uses both half cycle of the applied AC voltage and converts an AC voltage into the plusing DC voltage. Full wave rectification, one diode conducts during one half cycle while other conduct during the other half cycle of the applied AC voltage. It has some advantages over the half wave rectifier, like it has high average output DC voltage and has much fewer ripples, resulting in the smoother output waveform. Waveform of half wave rectifier output voltage. Half wave rectifier is a low efficiency. Its efficiency are so low, half wave rectifier does not require center tapping of the secondary winding of the transformer. Half wave requires less electronic components, means have a cheap one and have less electronic components. The half wave possesses DC saturation. The half wave circuitry have possess DC saturation of transformer core. So full wave rectifier is a high efficiency. Full wave rectifier have much efficiency than half wave rectifier. Full wave rectifier requires center tapping of the secondary winding of transformer. Full wave requires more electronic components, while half wave is less electronic components. The wave possess DC saturation in full wave can be overcome in possesses DC saturation. The full wave circulatory does not possess DC.
Assalamu alaikum, my name is Sharifullah. Registration number in 17NTU1108. So the topic of my presentation is discuss inserts, update, mass assign methods. So let's discuss one by one. The number one is inserting method. So number one is inserting method. What is inserting method? To insert a data, simply we can say that to insert a data. Types of inserting methods are insert, we can say that the query we can use to insert a data is insert into, and then we can write the table name and then columns and then values. So this is a simply code I want to show that how we can insert data. We will also practically in PHP Storm. So let's go there to perform that how we can insert data practically. So here we are PHP Storm IDE. Before we discuss our topic, we literally touch MEC. What's mean MEC, model view and controller. So what is model? Model is basically attached with the database to fetch or save data in the database. Controller is attached with a model to get data from the model and provide it to the view. So to not too much consuming our time, I already created model, controller and view. This is the view where we created a table, and this is another view where we are created a simple form to get data, post data, and this is a controller being the code of inserting, and this one is the web dot to give a root. So here we discuss our main topics, insert data in a database. Here I created three methods. Number one is index, number two is created student, create student and save student. Now the create student just only return our which view, create student, this view. And our main code of insert data is this one. We created the object of our model. Why we are creating the object of our model? Because we already discussed that the model is attached with a database to fetch or post data from the database. So here we create a object of our model, which is student. This one is the model. By this input request, we get data from the from here, which is fname, and this one is a label and input where we are post data, and where we are going to store here, and the same here. Now when we get data from here and store here, we just only save. This command will save a data in our table which we are created in our database. Here this one, student, where F, first name and last name.
Assalamu alaikum. My name is Aurangzeb and my registration number is 17NTO0041. The topic of my presentation is historical perspective of freedom movement of Pakistan. It was a political movement in the first half of 20th century that aimed for and succeeded in the creation of dominion of Pakistan from the Muslim majority areas of British of India. बैकग्राउंड जो है इसका वो है पाकिस्तान फ्रीडम मूवमेंट स्टार्टेड ओरिजिनली एज द अलगीरा मूवमेंट लेटर ऑन कैद आजम एंड अलामा मोहम्मद इकबाल आल्सो द पार्ट ऑफ दिस मूवमेंट विच इज नाउ एज फ्रीडम मूवमेंट ऑफ पाकिस्तान. सो कैद आजम वॉज अ पाकिस्तानी बैरिस्टर पॉलिटिशियन एंड फाउंडर ऑफ पाकिस्तान फ्रॉम 25 December 1876 एंड to 11 September 1948. Qaid Azam played a very important role to the in the Pakistan, served as the leader of All India Muslim League from 1913 until Pakistan creation on 14 August 1947, and become Pakistan's first Governor General until his death. In 1940, Jinnah said, "Hindus and Muslims belong to two different religions, philosophies, social customs, and literature. It is quite clear that Hindus and Muslims draw their inspiration from different sources of history. They have different epics, different heroes, and different episodes." So there is a Muslim League conference in Lahore. On this conference, Muslim formally recommitted itself to creating an इंडिपेंडेंट मुस्लिम स्टेट. यहाँ पे लाहौर में एक कॉन्फ्रेंस हुआ था, उसमें मुसलमानों ने जो है एक अलग स्टेट, मुस्लिम स्टेट का वो जो था मांगा था कि हमने एक अलग स्टेट जो है ना बनाना है, मुस्लिम स्टेट. उसके बाद दूसरा आता है मोहम्मद अलामा मोहम्मद इकबाल. अलामा मोहम्मद इकबाल वॉज अ पोइट, फिलासफर, थ्योरिस्ट एंड बैरिस्टर इन ब्रिटिश इंडिया. Iqbal's poems, political contributions, and academic and scholarly research were distinguished. He inspired the Pakistan movement in subcontinent. So, spiritual father of Pakistan, Allama Iqbal ko Pakistan ka spiritual father bhi kaha jata hai. Allama Iqbal also known as spiritual father of Pakistan for this contribution to the nation. Allama Iqbal ideologically separated from Congress Muslim leaders. Iqbal had also been distrusted with the politicians of the Muslim League owing to the factional conflict that plagued the League in the 1920s. Discontent with the factional leaders like Shafi and Fazlur Rahman, Iqbal came to believe that only Jinnah was a political leader capable of preserving unity and fulfilling the League's objective of Muslim political empowerment. So Allama Iqbal exposed the idea of Muslim majority prevalence in 1930. Allama Iqbal also said that, "Known you are a busy man, but I do hope you won't mind my writing to you often. As you are the only Muslim in India today to whom the community has right to look up for safe guidance through the storm which is coming to Northwest India and perhaps to the whole India." Sir Syed Ahmad Khan. Sir Syed Ahmad Khan, a great Muslim leader and a great philosopher, every time Muslims was forced by Sir Syed to get a modern education, Sir Syed Ahmad Khan जो है ना उसने बहुत important role अदा किया है. वो हमेशा जो है ना मुसलमानों को modern तालीम करने के लिए वो तरीक दे देते कि मतलब modern तालीम हासिल two nation theory. Sir Syed Ahmad Khan was a first man in subcontinent history to introduce a word two nation for Muslim and Hindus. Sir Syed Ahmad Khan ने पहले पहले जो two nation theory जो है ना उसने इसका idea पेश किया था और ये इसका pioneer था. He is the pioneer of two nation theory. मेन रीज़न टू नेशन थ्योरी, इसकी इसका रीज़न क्या था टू नेशन थ्योरी का? द मेन रीज़न वाज द डाउनफॉल ऑफ मुस्लिम हिंदूज कंट्रोवर्सली लीग प्रॉब्लम्स एंड द हेटर्ड बाय हिंदूज एंड ब्रिटिश अपॉन मुस्लिम्स ऑफ साउथ एशिया. इसका जो मेन रीज़न था वो ये था कि हिंदू और मुस्लिम जो है ना वो नॉन एक्सेप्टेंस बिहेवियर थे एक दूसरे के. उसके बाद जो है ना सर सैयद अहमद खान ने ये रियलाइज किया था कि दोनों जो है नेशन है ना वो अलग अलग, उसके बिहेवियर रहने सहने का तरीका सब कुछ अलग अलग है, तो वो एक जगह नहीं रह सकते. सर सैयद अहमद खान स्टेट दैट, "आई एम कन्विंस्ड नाउ दैट हिंदूज एंड मुस्लिम्स कुड नेवर बिकम वन नेशन एज देयर रिलीजन एंड वे ऑफ लाइफ वॉज क्वाइट डिस्टेंट फ्राम ईच अदर." सो ये सर सैयद अहमद खान ने कहा था कि दोनों के जो है ना रिलीजन, लाइफ जो है उसकी वो सब कुछ एक दूसरे से अलग है, सो इसलिए वो एक साथ नहीं रह सकते. किलिंग रेशो ऑफ मुस्लिम एट दैट टाइम, Christopher report, scholar Christopher says the number of Muslim killed were between 20,000 and 1 lakh. उस टाइम क्रिस्टोफर जो है ना एक रिपोर्टर था, उसने एक रिपोर्ट तैयार की कि उस टाइम जो है ना मुस्लिम जो किल हो गए थे, किल्ड हो गए थे, वो उसका जो रेशो था वो 20,000 से लेकर 1 लाख तक था. एंड देर इज यूसुफ सर सर्फ जस्ट यूसुफ सर्फ एस्टिमेट बिटवीन 20,000 टू 30,000, मच हायर फिगर वेर रिपोर्टेड बाई न्यूज पेपर एट दैट टाइम. मतलब ये सबसे ज्यादा रेशो थी उस टाइम जो है ना न्यूज़पेपर पे रिपोर्ट की गई थी 20,000 से लेकर 30,000 तक. उसके बाद है हमारे पास कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल एलिमेंट एंड सोशल कंप्लायंस. कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल एलिमेंट, द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन प्रोवाइड्स द राइट ऑफ लिविंग टू ऑल द सिटीजन ऑफ दिस स्टेट नेम्ड इस्लामिक रिपब्लिक ऑफ पाकिस्तान. The government should be held accountable for the deprivation of life caused to any person due to any reason that affect life in any capacity. The existence of a human being that were a right to life is. So the third element is protection against retrospective punishment. It is a civilized clause and it upholds that people should not be punished for acts which have yet to be declared offenses. The fourth one is dignity of a person. Dignity and privacy both invaluable but subject to law. No person gets to be respected and dignified if law says otherwise. What the clause does not say is that a person should be entitled to dignity on his face, but not otherwise. It should be a right of any person who is born to be respected, to be dignified. The other element is freedom of assembly association. This right in the constitution can be for some but not for all of us, since I hardly arrange processions or form partnerships ever. Good for the people who need it though. Right to information, it's another element of constitutional social constitutional. This right is right to information. It is my fundamental right to be informed, but how keep I am I to be informed, and that too with healthy information. Another one is forced labor. All forms of forced labor and traffic in human being are prohibited. Then protection against retrospective punishment. No law shall authorize the punishment of the person for number one, for an act or omission that was not punishable by law at the time of the act or omission, or for an offense by a penalty greater than or of a kind different form. The penalty prescribed by law for that offense at the time the offense was committed. Then provision as the property. Every citizen shall have the right to acquire, hold and dispose of property in any part of Pakistan subject to the constitution and any responsible restrictions imposed by law in the public interest. Right to education. The state shall provide free and compulsory education to all children of the age of 5 to 16 years in such manner as may be determined by law. ये तो हमारे पास कॉन्स्टिट्यूशनल एलिमेंट आ गया. इसके बाद जो है ना सोशल कंप्लायंसेस है. इसमें हमारे साथ जो हम मतलब एज अ गुड सिटीजन हमें कैसे रहना चाहिए, तो उसके लिए जो है ना कुछ पॉइंट्स है, ये हॉनेस्टी टेल द ट्रूथ, मतलब हॉनेस्टी के साथ हमें रहना चाहिए एक मुआशरे में, इंटीग्रिटी टू बी मॉरल अपराइट, रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी टू बी अकाउंटेबल फॉर योर सेल्फ एंड योर एक्शंस, आप जो अपने मतलब हर चीज़ के लिए रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी लेना चाहिए, रिस्पॉन्सिबल होना चाहिए बंदा, रिस्पेक्टफुलनेस, ट्रीट अदर हाउ यू वांट टू ट्रीटेड, जैसे दूसरों को ट्रीट करोगे वैसे आपको भी वैसे ही ट्रीट करना करेंगे वो, तो रिस्पेक्टफुलनेस होना चाहिए, रिस्पेक्ट देना चाहिए, कंपैशन, शो फेलोशिप विथ योर कंपेट, शो फेलोशिप विथ योर कंपेट्रेट्स हु आर डाउन ऑन देयर लक बाय वॉलंटियरिंग एंड आर मेकिंग डोनेशन टू चैरिटीज। उसके बाद हमारे पास काइंडनेस है, टू बी फ्रेंडली विद एवरी वन, ट्रोलेंस है, टू बी ट्रोलेंट ऑफ अदर रेसेस एंड रिलीजन्स। उसके बाद कॉर्टेसी, टू बी कंसिडरेट ऑफ अदर, सेल्फ डिसिप्लिन, हैव सेल्फ कंट्रोल एंड कल्टिवेट यू द एबिलिटी टू फॉलो थ्रू ऑन व्हाट यू से यू आर गोइंग टू डू। ये छंद हमारे पास जो है ना सोशल कंप्लाइंसेज है, हमें गुड सिटीजन के बनने के लिए हमारे पास जो है ना ये छंद पॉइंट्स हैं, इसको मद्देनजर रख के आप एक गुड सिटीजन बन सकते हो। थैंक यू। सिचुएशन इंटरेस्ट।